When it does rain in Kenya, it's torrential. The end of my visit coincided with the beginning of the rainy season. The first downpour quickly turned the ground a deep rusty red. This life-giving water turns arid plains into flourishing grassland and scrub, which supports the huge herds Africa is famous for. I travelled north with my friend Pete, and we stayed a night in Old Kajeta, a vast nature conservancy in the shadow of Mount Kenya. Here, we encountered a huge variety of typical savanna wildlife, such as this grazing herd of buffalo. They are notoriously short-tempered animals and can be very dangerous given their size and strength. Some of the birds were enormous as well. I initially admired this group of ostriches, but on closer inspection they appeared rather ugly, with their fleshy legs and bare necks. However, their size was very impressive, and I was excited to be looking at the largest birds on the planet. Bustards looked more elegant. Male Cory's bustards, such as this one, are thought to be some of the heaviest flying birds. One of my favourites, however, were the secretary birds, eagles on stilts, with magnificent crests. They pranced around, looking for prey items such as lizards and small snakes. Near a watering hole, we came across some baboons, a large troop with some very young individuals. As with any family group though, there are bound to be some conflicts. They attracted a bit of attention, but the smaller one escaped unharmed. Out on the plains again, we came across these wonderful animals. We even spotted a very small infant being closely escorted. Giraffes are extremely elegant. Rarely seen running, they appear to live a calm and slow-paced life. We were lucky to see quite a number of these animals, and interestingly enough, I learnt that each one has a unique pattern of spots. This has been used by scientists to track individuals and study this iconic species. This one was host to an oxpecker, cleaning the giraffe of parasites. A bit sensitive there, maybe. I was so transfixed, I could have watched them for hours. As the sun began to set, we left the giraffes to their dinner and made our way to camp to have ours. By now, the troop of baboons was roosting in the treetops, safe from ground predators prowling around at night. We didn't have that luxury, however, and after dinner around the campfire, we crawled into the tent for a rather nervous night's sleep. Life awakens early on the African plains, and we were treated to a spectacular view as the sun rose over the top of Mount Kenya. To give us a feel for what might have walked right past us in the darkness, we came across this pair of black rhinos in the bush, literally just a few hundred meters from where we had slept. They were impressive beasts, and I was surprised, if a little apprehensive, at how sharp their horns were. Later in the day, we were extremely privileged to spot a white rhino with a calf. They were quite inactive by now, simply enduring the sun at its hottest. Zebras made up some other large herds. The broad stripes mark these out as plains zebras. Feeding on the fresh grass produced by the recent rain, their manes rippled in the warm breeze. We also spotted the more endangered Grevy's zebra, told apart by its much thinner stripes. Harterbeest resembled domestic cattle, with their short horns and thick build. They are some of the larger species of antelope. In the midday sun, they stood like sentinels, motionless and constantly alert. This energetic youngster clearly didn't know how to behave properly, though. Impala were generally a lot more active. The impressive horns on the males contrasted with their much more fragile appearance, typical of the smaller gazelles. This mother had left the herd to give birth in a secluded area. Her fawn will have been born in time to coincide with the beginning of the rainy season, when food is most abundant. After a few days, mothers return to the herd with their offspring to form a nursery group. A less familiar grazer of the savannah is the warthog. They looked amusing shuffling around on their front knees to feed. Their tusks can be used to dig for food, but they're most useful in violent ritual fights, when two animals charge at each other and clash heads. At last we got good views of an elephant. This big male was sheltering in the shade of a tree, and unfortunately had an injured hind leg, but at least it was under the protection of the rangers. We stopped to ask for the best areas for big cats, eager as we were to see some predators. However, another close encounter came when this Sykes's monkey decided it had had enough of the natural food available and took to peering into visitors' cars, in case they had left any of their food unattended. Always on the lookout. Vultures gathering are normally a sure sign of a recent kill. But to our surprise, the most formidable predators we saw were lurking in the water. These crocodiles lay motionless, but they can swim at speeds of up to 20 miles an hour. One of my favourite animals, though, had to be the jackals. We saw a few small family groups on the edge of the plains. Very similar in appearance to foxes, their rusty coloured flanks looked magnificent in the early morning sun. A beautiful animal to end an amazing and unforgettable trip.